that move to put Danny in there, and it paid off, didn't it?
Well, it wasn't. I didn't make the move to thinking that he would get a base hit in the bottom of the ninth off a right-handed slider, I can tell you that. And they brought in their situational lefty. I just thought we needed to take a shot right there. And I knew that if the game got tied or we fell behind, that he would probably have to face Vincent later on. And, you know, you got to give a lot of credit to Danny. He didn't make the trip last week. He practiced all week with a great attitude. I told him earlier in the week that he was going to get an opportunity and to be ready. He had a good week of practice. I went out there and told him after the first, Foster was sacrificed to second base, I said, look, you're going to get nothing but sliders from this kid. He's got a really good late-breaking slider, and he's been throwing it nothing but that pitch to the right-handed hitters. So I said, let's take a strike so that you can track the ball well. And then after you get a strike, when you see it good and you put a good swing on one, you can send us on happy, and certainly we did.
For all the hype leading up, how does this compare, obviously, you know, going down and winning it in the ninth inning?
Yeah, well, it was a tremendous college baseball game. And if you're a fan of college baseball, how does it get any better than this? So we got a packed house at Allen Fox Stadium, top two teams in the country in the polls. Both teams played their hearts out, and we give a lot of credit to Texas A&M the way they play. I give a lot of credit to my team. By Jared Pershaw, who gives up a leadoff double, and they're rocking for a run. You know, we make an error in the second inning that leads to a run, and then he throws up, you know, five shutout innings for us. Parker Budd comes in and makes a big pitch. And Godfrey made some big pitches. Straw made the biggest pitch, throwing a strike on the 3-2 pitch with the bases loaded. And our kids just kept battling as well. What you saw was a game battle, whatever you want to call it, between two very evenly matched teams. And it shouldn't come as a surprise to anybody. We played these guys six times in the last 2 years, and five of them have been one-run games. And one team had a blowout of a three-run win, and that's the biggest margin there's ever been between these two teams. So I told Rob after the game, I said, I think we're going to have games like this for the next 10 years, so we might as well be used to it.